Mike sees something he likes very much. He decides to go after it, and he finds what he wants.
A typical moped has a motor, and it has pedals, like a bicycle. And you get the split between the two words, motor, pedals, and you get moped.
It can either be powered under its own power, or if something goes wrong or breaks down or you run out of gas, you can pedal it like a bicycle.
This form of transportation is becoming more and more popular all across America.
I started working on mopeds way back in my teen years when my father helped me buy one, because I took it for its first checkup at the Honda shop, and they literally walked around it, changed the plug, and charged me like $45. So I decided I could do that myself.
I grew up in Pennsylvania, so it's kind of not much to do around there in the hills, so we just rode bikes and stuff.
And I use the scooter to go downtown, where I work downtown in Wilmington, and it's about 4.5 miles one way.
Well, all scooters and mopeds are going to be like small engines. Scooters are automatic. They have kind of like a variable belt drive transmission. This one's all internal, little clutches and stuff. Give it the gas, it goes. Pretty much dependable.
You're on a public road, you have to be 16 or older. The other requirement is you have to wear a DOT approved helmet. So those two things you must do.
This is the time to put on the safety helmets, even though some people object.
That's a big issue. I mean, I like the helmets. I wear a 3/4 face helmet, which is comfortable. You know, I'd like it if it was my choice, but I'd still probably wear one.
Sorry, no room for a passenger, unless you have one of the few mopeds equipped for a second rider.
I feel safe riding them because I know what I can do. I mean, it's all about the driver, you know. You're in charge, you're in control, just like you ride driving in a car. You got to watch what's going on around you. Nobody's gonna look out for you but you. Whether you're driving a Honda or a truck or a moped or a scooter, you just got to be paying attention.
If I mean downtown area, speed limits down here are like 25 for the most part anyways, so just to go like 6-7 blocks or 12 blocks, it's totally safe.
In traffic, the word is drive defensively, as in any vehicle.
I feel like most of the time around here, if you're paying attention to traffic and what's going on, you're more or less safe, and always wear your helmet, of course.
It's a two-person event. You know, you being the scooterist have to take responsibility, and then you have to sort of be alert of the other drivers as well. But if you, the scooterist, play your part in it, as I try to do, then I feel very safe.
You see people come in, you're like, have you ever ridden before? They're like, oh yeah. You put them on it, they give it the gas, it starts to take off, it scares them. They're trying to grab the brakes while they're holding the gas wide open. That's not gonna work. The thing's still gonna push, you know? So I mean, if you haven't been on it and you know you haven't been on it and you just want one, go get it and take it to a park or something. Ride it around, get used to it. Do it somewhere where you're not gonna hurt anybody except yourself. Everybody's gonna fall sooner or later. So, I mean, get it out the way.
Of course, then there's the gas factor, which, these things are great on gas.
To fill the tank? Oh, like $2. Yeah, it's like a gallon of gas, basically. I don't even think it holds the whole gallon. I fill up a gallon of gas can, I think I get like $1. It goes 100 miles.
Not only is it tied to gas prices, as gas prices go higher, more and more people will look at alternative means.
This day and time, people are a lot more sensitive to environmental issues. They look at, global warming. People are just looking for viable means of transportation to lessen their carbon footprint, if you will. And also, you save a lot of money.
Parking's very expensive. And currently, I've been told that the scooters require no special parking permit, which costs lots of money if you have one for a car.
When I'm local, it's really nice to get back and forth and not have to worry about parking or gas. I can just wheel right in here and park it when I come down to work.
I think you can zip right up to the building or dorm or whatever that you need to zip up to and act like a bicycle, lock it up there, and you're good to go. You don't have to walk 10 minutes, from your parking space.
Another thing that was appealing about it was the fact that you don't have to get insurance or a separate license if it, you know, doesn't go so fast, which I'm sure would be astronomical for a moped. Yeah. Kidding.
And as far as getting where I need to go and doing the things I need to do, this is really all I need.
It's not for long rides or interstate riding. I mean, they don't go that fast and they're not legal to go that fast. But, you know, for running around town, getting back and forth to work real quick, it's fun. It's great. It's a pastime. It's a hobby for me. I mean, you know, I just enjoy it.
And never forget the fun factor. It's a whole lot of fun out here buzzing around.
It didn't take Mike very long to become an expert moped driver. He really got what he wanted.
Lightning, heavy metal thunder, racing with the